Okay, hello. So, if you've been following this, I've slept since the last video. Basically, I slept last night from 5 until 1 a.m. and then I slept this morning from 8 a.m. till, I think, 1 p.m. So, I'm well rested. I had 2 coffees, because I naturally, well, I don't know if you want to call it naturally, but at any rate, I have 2 coffees a day, pretty much all the time, minimum, like just to wake up. And so now I'm slightly anxious. It's like this ambient low-level anxiety, and it's preventing me from doing my routines. I want to go for a walk, but I'm making excuses why I don't walk. I've been actually pretty good at, like, typically going for walks every day, with some exceptions on the weekend when I'm with Melissa. But I think the exercise God forgives me for that. So I also have been putting off making more guitar videos. Yesterday I made 5, I think, well, what counted as yesterday, which is a lot, and I know I don't need to do that many, but I'd like to at least make 1 for today. And I'm going to stop talking because pretty much not supposed to talk. I mean, I don't know if there's... There's no rule book that I'm playing by. I think what I'm doing here is a little bit uncommon, at least. But I feel I should have at least 1 guitar video a day. So here we go. Sounds a little off about that. I think I'm doing the same thing, but producing different sounds, which might have something to do with the fact that I have the tone one of them was maxed out. See, I think I'm a little bit shaky. I don't have full muscle control, and that's probably from the little bit of anxiety that I have, but let's go through this again. It still sounds different when I'm more or less doing the same thing. Thank you. have temptation to go two ways. First of all, obviously I want to go to D. This is obvious if you've seen my previous videos. But I also want to look a little bit more at the C minor that I added to the official chart. We got two mutes. I haven't figured out how to accurately just strum. Like, I can strum. I'm pretty good at strumming one mute, like the sixth string mute, but strumming two mutes, so the fifth and the sixth, that's where it gets a little bit complicated in my brain. This is C major, I think. I think that only has one mute. Yes. I feel I'm not playing as good as the previous video, or maybe I'm learning more. Like, I'm very well rested. I mean, I do want a coffee, but I don't think I'm falling asleep or anything like that. Doing that pretty good yesterday, so that's the same. So yeah, let's do the D. We were planning to do some D and two mutes. These, like, a chord like this is it's very easy to not worry about muting the neighboring strings with something like this. So you see, I'm muting this chord here with this finger, and then I'm muting this chord here with this finger, and so because this chord string, a string is a chord, that's why I'm saying it without the H. Anyways, so because this string is muted down here, this guy doesn't have to worry about his fat finger knocking into this. Like, this guy is on this string, and he doesn't have to worry about knocking into this string because of where this chord is muted. You got the idea. I don't know if I could be any more simple. It was probably too simple. And then with the index, it's the first string. So, like, if I were to pluck a string there and then worry about the next one. See, when I was holding it like that, that would be like holding it like that, and that would result in You see? I don't know why I'm turning this into guitar lessons. I doubt anyone watching knows less than me. I doubt that. So... Same idea. This guy doesn't have to worry because of this guy. Right. D7. Two mutes. Right. That guy has to worry. Okay. Whoa. Sit up straight. I'm using my psychic powers. Using my psychic powers to explain when I should be using my psychic powers to play. Maybe I'm explaining it to myself. I don't know. So I sound like Wesley Crusher. Let's do this. And then let's compare it to this. Doesn't that sound similar? Maybe I'd have to move between them faster. So I also like this C minor. I think I said it felt like I was cheating because it's like basically halfway down the board, and I was looking at all these C minors that were impossible up here, but C minor, this is very doable. It's a very doable chord, and it's halfway down. And maybe there's a reason why there's no easy C minors up here. Then of course we have G, which, as I have learned, I have to just make sure my elbow has space to move. Wasn't perfect. I think I semi-muted some things, and let's just try the first. Nope. Too slow. Okay. Okay. Developed this theory over a few videos that you kind of have to just go with it with this chord, but maybe that's not right. That nail was getting too long and it was preventing me from putting complaints in this drum. There's like, I think, do you know what I mean? I hope the mic is good enough that you know what I mean when I say I hear complaints. If you want to develop a callus, which I kind of, I have the beginnings of, I'm not satisfied with it yet, but just try to learn the G chord in that way, because that, I mean, it basically got each one of my fingers crying out in pain, E7, C7. To the pain. First of all, it's not strong enough. Second of all, it hurts too much to sustain. Like, I was sustaining this with my pinky, and I didn't like that. So at least we attempted that one. And G minor, I don't know if I even have to bother. Like, I could only really see that for like plucking, like maybe the beginning of a song. kind of thing. I don't know if you can hear it. G7. We just did G7, didn't we? No. Okay. Well, G7's completely open. I feel like it's like this part of my hand is muting the first string, that's what I'm guessing. But anyways, it felt like it sounded like it was more or less what it was supposed to be. Even though when I was plucking individually, I was only getting it part of the time. That sounded more or less what it's supposed to be. Seemed like I was having difficulty there, but I wasn't. The thing is, the whole time my mind was on the fact that this finger is getting the most calloused, and I'm just noticing what I'm doing here. I'm running my hand over the length of the string, and the fact that I do that, I bet, like, obviously you can get a callus by pressing down on some notes, but you can, it might be, like, that's probably where you, I bet that develops a callus, just doing that. Just formed a bad memory. I was like, okay, one last time, and then the last time I did it, I messed up, basically, so, yeah. Nothing really new in this video, except maybe C minor. Okay, hold on now. Yeah, C minor. I did the last video, maybe the one before as well. But yeah, nothing really new. Just repetition. If anything, I have that on my sleeve. Things happen. I don't want to end by talking. Sorry.